season-ending surgery. That matchup will feature two prolific receivers in the league, veteran Larry Fitzgerald and fantasy juggernaut Julio Jones. Fitzgerald shared his thoughts on Jones.
Right at the top, you know, I think what he does really well is you can tell he's a student of the game. He studies it because what they're asking him to do in terms of all the personnel groupings and all the motions and spots that he's in, you got to be able to digest a lot of football and be able to understand why a coach is putting you in these spots. And he makes a lot happen with the target he gets.
For the Bears, quarterback Jay Cutler is officially out. Matt Barkley will start in his place versus the Titans. Saints running back Mark Ingram, recovering from a concussion and initially listed as questionable for today against the Rams, will play. Saints starting left tackle Teron Armstead is active after missing the last two games. For L.A., running back Todd Gurley is active. Jaguars running back T.J. Yeldon, coming off an ankle injury, is active versus the Bills. Buffalo wide receiver Sammy Watkins is playing for the first time since injuring his foot September 15th. He could be on a pitch count, depending on how he feels. Running back LeSean McCoy will be active as well, though expected to wear a splint on his thumb during the game. Other early kickoffs include Bengals at Ravens, Giants at the winless Browns, 49ers at Dolphins, Miami looking for its sixth straight win, and Chargers at Texans. Listen to NBC Sports Radio on your local station, online, or the free mobile app. This is Maria Marino, NBC Sports Radio, NBCSportsRadio.com.
Did you know that more than 100,000 people a day are downloading game apps? Mobile apps have become a normal part of everyday lives. Now there's a new exciting sports app that lets you play along with your favorite professional sports team in real time. With this fantastic app, you can predict the next play and even outguess your favorite team members. The more predictions you get correct, the more points you receive. Points can be exchanged for cool prizes, like your favorite jerseys, hats, airline tickets, sports tickets, even a new car. You can play this amazing sports app by yourself, with your friends, or even with a large group of fans from all over the world. This incredible sports app is called FireFan, and it's available right now. Check it out. Sign up today at www.freefirefanapp.com.
From the KCAA Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Jim Rinaldi. We have a wind advisory in effect. Well, this morning, clouds and showers becoming mostly sunny this afternoon. There'll be a gusty wind in parts of the area, the high temperature 58. Partly cloudy, less wind tonight, low 42. Monday's going to be a mostly sunny day, high 62. Partly cloudy Monday night, low 46. Tuesday and Wednesday will feature abundant sunshine with highs each day 68. Thursday and Friday will be sunny with highs of 66. That's your weather forecast for this hour from KCAA, 106.5 FM and 1050 AM, the stations that leave no listener behind.
Here's a look at the KCAA community calendar. I'm Mark Westwood. Good news for Inland Empire job seekers. Logistics company Radial is looking to fill 500 positions in their Redlands facility. With companies already gearing up for the holiday season, Radial needs to fill positions fast. Previously known as eBay Enterprises, the warehouse, called Radial, operates in Redlands and helps fulfill orders from the company's commercial clients. Those interested in one of the 500 jobs are encouraged to visit the company's website, radial.com. While the logistics company regularly employs 7,000 people globally, the firm plans to add more than 20,000 seasonal workers worldwide to increase efficiency during the holidays. I'm Mark Westwood, and that's a look at the KCAA Community Calendar. If you'd like to be included in the KCAA Community Calendar, go to kcaaradio.com and send us an email. This KCAA Community Calendar has been brought to you by Learn for Life Charter Schools, where you can change your story. Call 1-877-360-LEARN.
Inland Body and Paint is a family-owned and operated fleet collision and repair shop that's proud to live in and help our community. Bring your heavy-duty trucks and or equipment to their fleet collision and paint center in Fontana for expert collision repair services. With 35 years of experience, you're sure to receive quality workmanship at an excellent price from Inland Body and Paint Center. From fiberglass repairs to quality painting, they'll take care of your truck and equipment from top to bottom in their new 64-foot spray booth. By the way,
Inland Body and Paint of Fontana repaired and repainted the KCAA truck, and they can do the same job for your car, truck, or heavy-duty equipment. Inland Body and Paint, dedicated to the community and to your satisfaction. Call them today to learn what they can do for you. You can find Inland Body and Paint on Valencia in Fontana. Call them at 909-434-0466 or online at inlandbodyandpaint.com.
If you don't know what it's all about, Dr. Jolly will tell you on What's It All About, Wednesday afternoons at 3 on KCAA 1050 AM.
This is KCAA.
America, are we at our best now? Are we having our best years now, or are our best years ahead of us? Have they already passed us? You know, what's the deal? How are we going to feel about that? Jill Stein of the Green Party, the presidential candidate for the Green Party, has raised over $5-6 million in 2 or 3 days to pay for a recount. She's interested in the state of Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, and what's the other one? Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, and we'll give you that information in just a second. And the idea being that she's raised this money, she's going to ask for a recount. Wisconsin has already started the movement to add those votes up again. Why is she doing it? Evidently, she thinks that there's going to be some kind of impact on the election. Do you think that the recount is something that makes sense, or do you think it's something that is a waste of time and money? We'd be very interested in your response on that. You could join us today. Give us a call at 888-909-1050. I'd like to hear how you feel about things. And our friend David up in San Francisco, I know that you are concerned a lot about the potential of a recall. I'd like to hear what you feel about that. Give us a call. 888-909-1050. Who's that on the line? Mr. Torres. Let's get Mr. Torres up front here and see what his attitude is about this recount.
Hey.
Hey, how are you this morning, Robert?
I'm okay, but anyone in the seven cities below is not okay. How's that?
Okay, you're going to tell me why they're not okay in the seven cities below you. Now, the seven,
right,
let's let everybody know where you are. You're in Lytle.
Right, it's raining up here in Lytle Creek, and all the human waste that the federal government allowed to be deposited into Bonita Falls is now being directed into the seven cities' intake systems. Nevertheless, shall we go on with life in the Inland Empire?
Well, I don't know. You've just talked about people in the cities below you being poisoned with human waste in their water system, and now you want to change the subject?
But it's all the same subject, sir.
Yeah, I...
What I'm getting at, the subject is professional neglect.
Professional neglect. Okay, you're going to call it professional neglect. I believe if Mr. Evans was on the line, he would possibly put some more of the responsibility on the people who are on the suffering end of the stick. He'd probably ask questions about, you know, have they voted, the people who are receiving this nasty water, have they voted? Have they talked to their elected officials about this? Or is this something that's just been hanging around for a while? Robert, you're always talking about the water up in Lytle Creek, and I'm going to give you 5 minutes to open us up about the problem with the water.
Okay. I have to do a qualifier. The water that comes out of my tap is provided by Burlingame's organization called Vital Springs Water Company. That is a well over 400 feet deep into the Arrowhead San Bernardino aquifer. It's crystal clean, no fluorides, nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this same water comes out of the ground, and it goes down to the intake cities down below. Again, Rialto, Fontana being the closest, just two of the seven. At that point, now, it's not that anyone suffers unless you call being unduly taxed or being overcharged for something suffering. But, you know, we Americans don't seem to mind being overcharged as long as it's...
Well, if we're being how do we get overcharged if somebody's taking the impurities and human waste and all of that stuff out of the water so that I can drink it? And I think that's part of what you're saying. I mean, the people in the seven cities below you are not drinking water that is of that condition because it's going through a system to clean it out prior to their drinking it, right?
Yes. However, the water is pristine and pure, but for the professional negligence, and now the folks pay for the added cost of purifying it in their sum total delivery cost, which is close to the water bill.
Okay, so I think you're talking again, or still, about the fact that there is a shooting range in the Lytle Creek area that has been depositing lead shells and residue for how long has the shooting been going on up there?
Easily over 50 years,
okay,
but I do recall...
So the water above the water as it passes through the area where the shooting takes place, where the lead and all is being accumulated, that makes the water unfit to drink. And it comes
down... When I first started finding out about this water stuff, I was always told the solution to pollution is dilution. So I only figured it was that they diluted the hell out of the water until it was clean enough to drink. But then I see on days like today where the water flows are not carrying the regular sediment, but erosion due to the speed of the water and the aggregate removing the lead that has never been removed. So that's just one flow. On a second flow, we have a South Fork where you have the Bonita Waterfall, and all the folks that visit the area, not all, but many who have gone through the area have seen the human excrement and the waste deposited by the urban visitors.
Okay, so good.
Those two now flow into your intake systems.
Okay.
Now, the government complies, or the professional negligence gets off its negligence and complies, then it behooves them to find, utilize, and implement the necessary funding to ensure that the water is pure before it gets to your intake system.
So you would like to stop the people from visiting who are leaving waste, as well as stop the shooting that takes place at the gun range? What's the solution?
I'm not looking to stop anyone from doing anything.
Okay.
What I am looking is...
You know what we're going to have to do? We're going to have to take a short break, Robert. And this is Empire Talks Back. I'm Wallace Allen speaking to Mr. Robert Torres. He is updating us about the water conditions up in Lytle Creek. He's got a long-term issue with the fact that there's a shooting range that's depositing lead particles in the ground and it's getting in the groundwater, and that there's visitors who come up into the area who have no facilities for their personal waste, and they are not of the type to take it away with them. So there's an accumulation of waste prior to the water going into the system that cleans it for drinking for the seven cities below. Robert is concerned. We are too. We'll be back right after this, and we're going to continue to talk about things that concern us so that we can find out who's really responsible for making things happen the way we would like to see them happen. This is Empire Talks Back. Wallace Allen, be right back after this break.
You're excellent.
An illness can cost you more than you can imagine. Health insurance? Less than you may think. At Covered California, we can help you choose the right plan for you and find out if you qualify for health insurance at a lower cost. Covered California. It's more than just health care. It's life care. Visit coveredca.com to enroll or find free expert help today. Enroll by December 15th.
Publish your legal notice in West Side Story newspaper. For the best service and the best rates, call 909-384-8131. Publishing legal notices in the city and county of San Bernardino since 1990. West Side Story provides friendly expert service. Call 909-384-8131 to benefit from budget-friendly rates. Whether a fictitious business name, a name change, a divorce summons, or any other legal or public notice, call West Side Story Newspaper, 909-384-8131. 909-384-8131. That's 909-384-8131.
For more local radio every day, tune in to KCAA Loma Linda.
Empire Talks Back, Wallace Allen. Folks, there's things going on in the country, in the neighborhood, and we want to know who's in charge. Who is the person or the group that you need to call in order to make things happen in your community the way you want to? Is there a magic button? Can we call the mayor? Do we expect the mayor, the police? Who's in charge? What do we need to do in order to make our communities work the way we want to make them work? Mr. Robert Torres is talking to us about a water issue that's local but regional, because it's local to him, but that water spreads out and it's regional. I think we're going to end up talking again about personal responsibility for our actions, for what happens to our community, and all of that leads into a big issue. We just had a great election, one of the most watched and paid to elections of all time, but somehow it didn't get more people to vote in the United States than ever before. On a percentage basis. So, you know, who's in charge of this stuff? Are we the voters, the ones who are responsible for the indecisiveness or the lack of direction or the quick changes of direction that our government takes? You know, what's up? How do you feel about the recount, the potential of more confusion with this 2016 election? Is there a chance that the tide will turn? How would all of that make you feel? Robert, we've been talking about your water issue, and we'll probably need to get us a special show to speak specifically about that. But in general, we're talking about people, people's responsibilities, people being involved in making the actions and decisions that that rule this country. People didn't vote like they could have or possibly should have during the election, and now we're looking for a recount with the idea that it will possibly change the results. Of course, now Ms. Jill Stein tells us that that's not her main motivation in asking for this recount.
On this recount thing?
Yes.
I think one of the some of the numbers that showed this morning on CNN were close to 2 million civilians voted more for Hillary than did for Trump. So does 2 million popular vote mean anything when it comes to constitutional law being violated by a electoral college that neither you nor us nor we the people have selected?
Yes,
please explain that to me, because damn, I'm dumber than shit.
You sure are. You're probably just like the Robert. But listen, the people, boy, you just threw me all the way off. The idea, Mr.
Hey.
Evans, could I get Mr. Evans to step up? Bring Mr.
Please.
Evans in this. You know, the recount, Mr. Evans, what do you think about the aspect of the recount, whether the recount makes a difference in the final who won or who lost? Do you think that the recount itself is good policy?
The recount provides us an opportunity for more clarity in what has actually occurred.
The recount for Wisconsin is going to cost about $1 million or close to $1 million in fees, you know, which probably makes a lot of sense. The difference between the votes there was about 22,000 votes. Difference between Hillary and Mr. Trump. We go back and look at the election with Gore and Bush. I think there was, like they say, about 500 different votes difference, and that certainly would demand a recount. But we're looking at 22,000 votes. So are we anticipating a change, or, like you say, Mr. Evans, are we simply going through the process and procedure? One of the things Ms. Stein said was that it's more to verify the count, because there's so many questions about it and questions about use of these electronic voting machines. I personally think it's probably a good idea. Wonder, though, about the use of the money. Are we anticipating a change? And if we find that there was 23,000 vote swing in Wisconsin, and that those, what is it, 10, I believe 10 electoral votes would go to be taken away from Trump and could be brought back to Hillary. What kind of argument do you think that would create? What kind of circumstance do you think that would cause people to act like if the recount comes up with enough votes to change the result of the election? Mr. Torres, how would you feel about that?
We, the American people, due to living in our protected bubble, will allow those in power to do whatever they wish to do. Doesn't matter how often they violate our civil human rights, as long as you don't shut off my TV.
Mr. Evans. Well, so as long as we're being highly entertained, you can pretty much do to us what you want to. Mr. Evans, how does that strike you?
I didn't quite follow the last of what he said.
Well, basically what he said was, that...
Let me say it real English, okay?
Well...
Real English.
Say it again, Robert.
Because it's more comfortable to do nothing. So go on.
Well, what he's saying that as long as we're able to see TV and be entertained, that we're pretty much willing to let government do anything.
He's saying nada mañana, nada mañana.
Yes. Wait a minute. We'll do it later. Mr. Evans, I've heard you, and we've discussed this many times, talk about the responsibility that we as citizens have. That concept of responsibility seems to be a little different from the way Mr. Torres sees it. He seems to think that we are willing to abdicate our responsibility. Abdicate the throne. I've heard you say that. Respond, Mr. Evans.
Well, it turns out that when the Founding Fathers drew up the structure of government, they debated on whether or not to have a king. One person with absolute authority, they even considered vesting that kind of power in the president. However, the idea of having a king was repulsive because of what they had seen in Europe with the abuse of that kind of authority. So they decided that in the end that they were going to have a king, because they needed a king to structure the government. They needed a seat of absolute authority. So we have a king in this country, but we don't recognize it. The king is declared in the Constitution clearly to be we the people.
So when the people...
And that means as citizens, we have a responsibility just like a king did. Everybody thinks king sat around, did nothing, ate well and all that. But he was responsible for the well-being of the entire country and all the people in the country, as well as the protection of them from marauding invaders. So being in that position carries a lot of responsibility.
Being
and
in
I encourage
the...
everyone to get on the internet.
Am I hearing?
Hold on, Robert.
To war. To understand American history and what's important to us, liberty.
All right, Mr. Evans, I got your answer. We've got your answer. Robert, you
were... And we are the custodians of it.
Okay, that's very clear, Mr. Evans.
We the people.
Mr.
And
Evans.
When we don't vote,
Joe, help me out.
That's the same as the king.
Mr. Evans, you're very clear on the concept of king that you're offering, and it, you know, but you're making a statement that you're using the word king, but you mean we the people, and that the people are responsible, and that the people, what they do, should be as caring and as definite as the responsibilities as a of a king. Well, the people have clearly abdicated the throne in that sense, in that we are not voting. Enough people are not voting to make it clear what the people want, unless we accept the idea that if you don't vote, that you're willing to accept what other people decide to do. Mr. Torres, go on.
Wow. And double.
Do you agree, Mr. Torres, that the people have a responsibility, that they also have a power that is probably not being used as much as it should be?
Maybe if I keep it down, okay?
I'm sorry, Robert. I thought I asked that question fairly clearly. Let me try again. Do you think that the people have a responsibility?
Humanity then makes civil rights, civil law, which then allows government to enforce, enact civil rights, civil law. In that order, no any other order. So therefore, if the people voted for Hillary or Jill Stein, and Jill Stein won, it doesn't matter that Hillary has all of Wall Street, all of the Electoral College votes, but the people wanted Jill Stein. It was that simple.
Okay.
So we have an indication that...
Okay, so Robert, what you're suggesting is an entirely different argument. Robert, please.
Wait a second. Here's the point. The popular vote is going to be circumvented.
Yes. Okay, so that's a pretty... Robert, if I could get to it on this. We're going to take the short break, and when we come back, we're going to discuss this thing about the popular vote and electoral college, because that's pretty much been discussed. You're either going to get rid of it or you're not. You can't have both systems, and, you know, it seems to be a problem, but like most problems, the solution is probably right there on the face of it. This is Empire Talks Back. I'm Wallace Allen, speaking with our friend Leonard Evans, Mr. Robert Torres, Anthony Garcia, our mood master, is in the studio. And we're talking about, you know, what difference does it make about your vote if your vote wasn't full and everybody made the vote? What difference does it make if the government isn't doing exactly what we as the people want? And what difference does it make if we the people decide that we don't really care and let somebody else do it? So we'll talk about that when we come back.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, K292 FQ Riverside, and K293 CF Moreno Valley.
An illness can cost you more than you can imagine. Health insurance, less than you may think. At Covered California, we can help you choose the right plan for you and find out if you qualify for health insurance at a lower cost. Covered California. It's more than just healthcare. It's life care. Visit coveredca.com to enroll or find free expert help today. Enroll by December 15th.
Publish your legal notice in West Side Story newspaper. For the best service and the best rates, call 909-384-8131. Publishing legal notices in the city and county of San Bernardino since 1990. West Side Story provides friendly expert service. Call 909-384-8131 to benefit from budget-friendly rates. Whether a fictitious business name, a name change, a divorce summons, or any other legal or public notice, call West Side Story Newspaper, 909-384-8131. 909-384-8131. That's 909-384-8131.
This is Empire Talks Back. I'm Wallace Allen on the case for truth and justice with the right information to help improve the situation. One of the things you don't want to forget to do, folks, this is the era, the time frame for the Sagittarius birthdays. And those are some of the nicest people on the planet. And we don't want to forget them. And I want to say a special hello to my sister, Kathy. Girl, we really do appreciate knowing you. You are really important in the family, and thank you for being you. So, the rest of us, after saying happy birthday to those folks that we care about, have to prove it in terms of our social and personal responsibilities. What do we do when we have somebody elected that we don't particularly agree with? Are we going to sit around and complain? Do we try to create some kind of policy, or do we work close with the person to see if indeed maybe the ideas that they have are not as strange as we think? What is the human movement when responsibility comes up and we don't think that it's our turn? Make it simple. You know, you're a roommate and you've got a person who leaves the dishes dirty. Do you leave them? Do you wash them for them? But if you're a roommate, if you wash them, aren't you washing them for the house, for yourself? You know, where does one person's responsibility end and someone else's begin, especially in our society? We're facing potentially a recount, an election recount, based on people thinking that possibly that some things were wrong with the way it's going. The way the votes were counted, the way the votes were delivered. Part of our responsibility, I guess, as folks who want to keep things transparent, would be to let's make the vote available for a recount. Should we have to pay a lot of money to do that? Should the recount be more automatic? Would that help us be more accepting of election results that we don't like? I'm not sure. Robert, you are sitting on the edge of your seat. Talk to me.
I'm just, you know, well, it started raining hard, so now I really started getting concerned because it's raining hard enough to push those dirty diapers.
Get out of the rain, man. Get out of the rain.
Waterfall right into the water system.
Robert lives in a beautiful part of California, Lytle Creek. He's in the woods. He's right at the base of the mountains. It's a great place to be when the sun is shining and things are going smooth. But once the rains start coming in and the darkness flows, and then you start seeing things from upriver as they pass down through your backyard, we understand your issue with the water, Robert. What do we do with that? What do we do about that? You've got local people. You've got federal people. There's federal
the
issues involved with that
question.
Water.
Is sitting with Mr. Trump, okay? You see, and that is what has been done here. We have more than 26 years of non-compliance.
I'm going to disagree with you about non-compliance because they have been complying. They just haven't done what you think they should do.
No, sir. At this point, I say I'm going to...
The main point that we can cover today is when you disagree with the government's... when you disagree with what the government is doing, what are your steps? What can you do? Are you going to just be able to step... complain?
Thank you,
sir. Is there something else you can do?
Yes, thank you. You said, what can I do? First, I need to thank you for allowing me the opportunity to speak to all of us.
Yeah, that's a stall. Go ahead.
What I am doing is I am attempting to be a trumpet, a clarion, a bell. I'm the fool.
You are that. You
sure.
are that. And you've caught our attention. And so now, based on that, what can we do? What should we do? And that's just a general question, Robert. I'm not putting you on the spot to make you give us specific answers. But that's the general situation we as a people are in. Mr. Evans is saying that we, the people, are the king and that we have not only responsibility, but that we have some authority. Mr. Evans, could I get you to bring Mr. Evans on down? Mr. Evans, we the people may be the king, but we the people, when we find that there are things that are not the way we want them, how do we the people affect our power as the king?
I'll tell you what you do. You go and find the nearest mirror. You look in that mirror and you see yourself.
Okay,
you see in that mirror.
Okay, Leonard, we've got that
change.
Part. We've got
it's
that part. Mr. Evans.
You.
Mr. Evans.
In a
Mr. Evans, we've got
liberty,
that part.
And all
Joe,
that
help me out. Mr. Evans, please. We've got that part. We want to know, how do we as individuals make ourselves be powerful enough to deal with our responsibility as king? And we know that the answer is not going to be one that is simply answered by the guy in the mirror. We've got to form some kind of association, something to convince other people that our view has some meaning for them too. Let's see if Mr. Evans was able to hear that. Or if he was still talking, which is good because he's alive. But that's what we got to do. So when we get questions, we got to try to answer them. So Robert, I guess the question is again.
I have to agree with Mr. Evans on the king notion thing. We are definitely king, where we can sit down and feast.
We've already said that. Now, we've accepted that position.
Next to me, and I'm bombing the living hell out of his.
But Robert, both, you know, help me out with Robert, please. We get to this position where we just want to, you know, where we say, okay, we're responsible, but what do we do? How do we demonstrate that responsibility as individuals? I'm just questioning, can we as individuals do that, or don't we have to team up? Don't we have to find someone of like mind? Don't we have to find a resource that we can use to amplify our statement. Speaking on the radio is great, but when we speak on the radio, we may have to set up a meeting, and if to have the meeting, we've got to affect some kind of plan or policy to deal with the problem. Just talking about it doesn't do it. I feel great about the radio. I feel great about, you know, knowing that we are helping to spread concerns. But what do we really do?
Now, for those lawyers, what you're looking at is a lawyer that is looking to bring in a cognitive.
Did you say lawyer or warrior?
To our conflicting cultures, we have.
Did he say lawyer or warrior?
The United States that causes us to practice religious racism for the sole sake of capitalist profit against all of humanity.
Okay.
Eliminate that.
I guess we're afflicted with these new telephones that only have talker in. So give me a raise them up for me. We have these new telephones. They don't have a receiver where you get to hear what people are saying. They just keep talking. But we've got a couple of live wires on the line. A couple of gentlemen that probably represent most of us talk show hosts where we just want to talk. But the people depend on us trying to do things. When we have a common issue, and Robert's issue is common, it's the water. The concept of the recount is a common issue. Everybody said, well, the way that worked, Jill Stein came up with, I don't know, a couple of million people or hundreds of thousands of people who gave small amounts of money so that in 2-3 days she was able to raise over $5 million for the recount. That's a cooperative effort. That's something that a group of people can do when they find that they've got a problem. Let's see if we can bring Mr. Evans back down on the line. Joe, could you bring Mr. Evans back, please? Line two.
Works.
Mr. Evans.
People see it.
Mr. Evans.
They throw some money at it.
Mr. Evans.
They throw their time and energy.
Hey, Leonard, you've been off the air for about 5 minutes.
Let's get to the bottom line.
Okay, let's do it again. I'm sorry, folks. I bring these my associates on because they are full of vim and vinegar and fire, and I have no control over it. And I'm just glad that, you know, God has given me access to friends like that. I hope they're entertaining and informative to you. The fact is, folks, that though we do have responsibilities, okay, on this vote, on the idea of a recount with the vote. I remember when Mr. Trump was projected to be the loser, the clear loser in this presidential election, and the conversation was going in the direction of, well, if he loses, or he was saying, if I lose, it's because the vote is rigged and, you know, can't trust it. If the only way I could trust the vote is if I win. Well, he won, and now he trusts the vote. The Democrats, on the other hand, were saying, oh, the vote's going to be fine. Donald's not. I don't know why he's saying it's rigged. There's no proof of it being rigged. He should accept the vote. If it comes down, whatever the results are, he should accept it. Well, here we are. The tables turn. The winds of time always bring a new view, probably the one that was opposite of the one you had before. Remembering that as we set policy, I think, is pretty important. If I am upset because you don't hear me now, then I should be just as upset when I don't hear you. We've got to work it out. So it seems a little disingenuous for the Democrats to, at this point, say, we don't trust the election, we've got to do a recount. Whereas I think prior to the election, both parties should be willing to say, you know, I'll bet that the possibilities of everybody agreeing with the election results is going to be pretty small. So we ought to just automatically figure that in the places where we think it's a battleground state, we're going to do a very special thing in terms of how we do the election and how we count the votes. That to me seems like it would make sense, that the things that we know we're going to have some possible dispute about, that we go on and set up some type of reconciliation prior to getting to the point of we're going to throw each other away, and we're going to throw the baby away with the bathwater, throw the election away, throw not only the election away, but our whole democratic process, our whole aura of belief in that process. We've got to be careful, folks. We're grown-ups. When you're grown up, your decisions you make have an echo. There's no do-overs. Well, we're talking about a do-over on the count, but that shouldn't be a do-over. That should just be part of the procedure. Okay, folks, we're going to take this final break for the show, and we'll be back, and we'll see if Mr. Evans and Mr. Torres are still talking to themselves or if they are ready to talk back to us. I do appreciate them, but this is entertainment as well as information, and my friends are highly entertaining. Yes, sirree. We'll be right back to not laugh at, but laugh with two of the most wonderful people on the planet as far as I'm concerned. Robert Torres, Leonard Evans, these guys are folks that don't mind representing you. And they haven't been elected. And they don't mind. This is Empire Talks Back. I'll be right back after this short break. And folks, let's stay together.
Hey, I just learned that the health plan I got through Cover California provides preventive care services at no additional cost.
Man, that's like music to my ears. Now I don't have to wait until I need a doctor to see a doctor. I can get services like annual checkups, flu shots, both cancer and diabetes screenings without having to pay extra. That's definitely a song worth singing.
Covered California, it's more than just health care, it's life care. Visit coveredca.com to enroll or find free expert help. Enroll by December 15th.
Did you know Covered California offers a range of plans from brand name health insurance companies? So many, it's hard to list them all in one breath, but we'll try. Anthem Blue Cross, Blue Shield of California, Health Net, Kaiser Permanente, LA Care Health Plan, Molina Healthcare, Oscar, and Sharp Health Plan. Whew. And with our experts at your side, we'll help you make the right choice. Covered California, it's more than just health care, it's life care. Visit coveredca.com to enroll or find free expert help. Enroll by December 15th. Insurance companies vary by region.
Publish your legal notice in West Side Story newspaper. For the best service and the best rates, call 909-384-8131. Publishing legal notices in the city and county of San Bernardino since 1990. West Side Story provides friendly expert service. Call 909-384-8131 to benefit from budget-friendly rates. Whether a fictitious business name, a name change, a divorce summons, or any other legal or public notice, call West Side Story Newspaper, 909-384-8131. 909-384-8131. That's 909-384-8131.
KCAA, where every day is a great day.
Empire Talks Back. I'm Wallace Allen. We're here on the case for truth and justice, hopefully to entertain and inform you, to make your life a little bit better and your desire to contribute and make other people's lives better. Bring it to the surface. Mr. Garcia, boy, I wish you guys were all able to be here during the show, during in between the shows, so you could hear some of the highly educated things that we say to each other. Boy, we'd be put off the air of some of the things Mr. Garcia is allowed to say.
Man,
I'm so surprised at you. So that's why God made you such great fingers to play that guitar with, because he just knew your mouth was going to be out.
What do you say? The devil gave you the mouth?
Yes, no doubt. Listen, let's bring up Mr. Torres and Mr. Evans and see if they are still. Mr. Torres is quiet. Mr. Evans is quiet.
Right here.
All right.
Talk about why things are going to get better.
Well, things are better. I think one of the things that help us decide that things are going to get better, and I agree, Mr. Evans, that was one of our topics.
Well,
are things better now?
Right. Things are good now.
However,
our best days are still ahead of us.
That's the idea.
As a country.
Okay.
And everyone should be on the lookout in the anticipation.
As we say that, and we...
For the opportunities that are going to come with this.
And we say that, and we just, you know, finished discussing how important it is for people to realize that what they say and do is the cutting edge, probably, of how things are going to affect them personally. What do you do with information?
That
what do you do to make things better?
About.
Yes. So what makes you think things are going to be better than they are? What's the great encouraging thing for you as you look at the future, Mr. Evans?
That America has so much to work with that we can turn to our benefit in a major way.
Such as?
Very quickly. The U.S. is the world's number one energy producer.
Okay.
That's enough by itself to make any country wealthy and powerful. Look at Saudi Arabia.
That's right. And their energy production is based on oil.
Top research labs.
Let's not change the
fascinating things.
Let's not change the topic.
Most people think that America doesn't make anything anymore.
Hold on, Leonard.
The truth is American companies in factories they own here in the U.S. and including factories that they own in other countries make and sell more than 40% of everything made and sold on the planet Earth. Less than 5% of the world's population.
Oh, wow.
Also,
okay, please?
You know, we have the ability to make things is what I'm getting at. And now there are several trillion dollars in offshore business bank accounts.
Okay. So economically,
we're going to work out a deal to bring that money back into this country. That will be invested in new businesses, new products, new industries.
Okay, so that's
new
a
new materials.
That's what you see as
that are
the thing that's encouraging.
About, but if you follow this kind of stuff, you see that things stronger than steel and lighter than steel, all kinds of. It gets too technical to talk about it on that side.
Well, no.
Then you've got the infrastructure and all of the jobs that represents and all of the improvements for the economy it represents.
Okay.
You know, when the roads are not well
all right,
repaired,
Joe, help me out.
You're wearing out tires, beating up your...
Wrong one. Okay, so Mr. Evans is pretty well lit up on the economic opportunity that's represented. Though we'll note that economic opportunity has pretty much been the same for several, maybe a couple of decades. How our future evolves is going to be very important. He was speaking about the technical aspects. Do you disagree, Mr. Torres, about the future of America? Are we in our declining days, or are we getting better?
Okay.
It's not a change of subject, Robert. This is the progression that we go in. We're in the last 15 minutes. The last 15 minutes of the show, we don't want to complain. We want to excite people.
Okay. The economic that I can see coming in for Inland Empire, and from Inland Empire, I'm saying anyone who has a household anywhere within this five-county region, under a collective, electrical, collective, sustainable energy collective, they can use their infrastructure to produce clean energy to electrify any and all of our needs.
So
while
you
at the same time recovering enough to keep those systems working. So we're looking at jobs, sustainable jobs, etc. Except for one thing. Right now there is a policy, law, whatever, that prevents this Joe Q citizen from achieving recovery costs on the excess energy that they produce.
Okay, so Robert, that's a little specific, and you're saying that we need to pay attention to the electrical grid and how the promises are being made for production of electricity. The question is, Robert, do you think that America's future is brighter in front of us, or do you think we're in decline, and why? And so do you think America's is ahead?
From the biblical analysis of society, and this society being way down low on performance in accordance to
I guess I don't know how to ask a question because I
we're supposed to live by.
Speak English.
Man, if that guy upset don't light us up worse than before, he's going to light us up soon. But we are lighting up. 6.5 million people across the world are dying just from lung pollution, which is attributed to...
So you want to blame God for that, or you want to blame people for that, or do you want to just say that, you know, that's a pretty small number compared to the 6 billion people that's on the planet? You know, I mean, we talk a lot about the hard numbers, but they live and they die, and people live and die every second on the planet.
There you go with your cultural racism.
My cultural racism.
One person dies from lung pollution, then all of us die from lung pollution. Because when you hurt one of us, me and Mano, you hurt all of us.
I love your romanticism, brother. That's why I got you on the phone, because I can depend on it no matter what else is going on. Let's bring Mr. Evans in. I want to make it clear. We've got about 3 minutes left. Mr. Evans, I want to give you about 35, 40 seconds to make a statement, and it's about the future of America and our responsibilities as individuals. Would you like to please take that topic and go?
Well, very quickly.
Please, it'll have to be quick, Leonard. We got about 30 seconds.
The football player who sat on the bench game after game after game. However, he always practiced and trained hard and stayed very prepared, because he knew the day would come when he would get put in the game. And at that point, you can't turn to the coach and say, "Hey, coach, hold on, I got to get ready." So what people need to do now, what I'm doing now, and always learning more about so I can get better at it, is preparing myself.
So that when it's your turn to go in the game,
for the opportunities that will come.
Very good.
I don't know exactly what they're going to be, but I am highly confident.
Mr. Evans is saying that if you're going to get in the game, you got to be ready. You don't know when your number is going to be called. And that's a very real statement. Mr. Robert Torres, give me 30 seconds. Tell us what you think is an important attitude for America to have. 30 seconds, Robert. You got about 25 now.
Rule of law or anarchy?
Very good. Rule of law or anarchy. Mr. Garcia.
Dialogue. Dialogue. If we don't have dialogue, like, say this is the world leaders here, the three of us, three of you. Where's the dialogue at? How are you communicating? You're talking, or they're talking, but there's no dialogue.
Okay, so in our future agenda, Mr. Garcia is suggesting that we have a solution phase, and I thought that's what we were trying to do here now at the end of the show, is to pretty much give people an idea that the world is still here, there's reason to be encouraged, and there is something that you can do to justify being encouraged. There's something that you can do to demonstrate not just your responsibility, but your authority. And with that authority, we have to go back at the things that we have some level of control over. We can control our own attitude. We can stay encouraged. We can control our attitude enough to go and participate despite being tired. We can control our attitude enough to appreciate the efforts of others, regardless of whether we agreed with those efforts from the beginning to the end. But we must agree that if the effort is there and the desire is there to make the world a better place, we should pay attention to it. Dialogue. That's what Mr. Garcia is saying. We have to have conversation. We have to talk to each other and listen to each other. And I'll have to say, we're not necessarily presenting a great example of that on the Empire Talks Back, but we're trying. And that, of course, is what we're all left to do, is try. Based on that, the recount is a justifiable thing. It allows us to clarify who we are, what we're doing, and why we're doing it. And that's something that we depend so, so strongly on. Our democratic process is something that we have to count on. And based on that, let's count the votes again. This is Empire Talks Back. I'm Wallace Allen. Look to see you next week under two circumstances. One, if the good Lord's willing. Two, if the creek don't rise. God bless you. See you then.
There's been so many things that held us down, but now it seems like things are finally coming around.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.
It's Football Sunday. This is Maria Marino tracking early NFL action in the second quarter across the board. Titans leading the Bears 14-7 after